Good morning, everybody, and welcome into your DFS Minute brought to you by DFSArmy.com, your one-stop shop for all things daily fantasy sports. I am Chopadong, and I'm going to be talking hockey a little bit today, but I did want to pause for just a second and remind everybody NBA is back. A lot of you have been scratching that itch all week long. You finally get the chance to build lineups again tonight. You've probably just overjoyed yourself to the point you've pulled hamstrings all over the place. But what I want to explain to you is that the content, tools, and coaching is running out like wildfire over there in the NBA department. The guys have been killing it all year long, and you can certainly build those lineups. But I'm going to talk a little bit more hockey, a little bit more NHL on that side of things, because while the NBA All-Star break has been going on, we've been doing a lot of teaching on the hockey side. We've found a lot of people that are interested, that are learning a new sport, are excited about it, are seeing results and winning. And so I'm going to focus a little bit more there in this video. But I wanted to remind you that it doesn't matter what you play at DFS Army, you can play both. You've got one roof over your head in terms of a subscription price, and you unlock an optimizer. You don't have to go somewhere else and pay for an optimizer. You've got all of the coaching for every single sport, NASCAR, MMA, PGA, whatever sport you want to play, we cover it. And we cover it well. We've got a track record on our wall of wins that would blow your mind. And we dive in and take the time to teach you how to become a better player in that sport. You don't have to pay for basketball and then pay again for hockey and then pay again for PGA. We have it all for about $50 a month. Less if you use that coupon code CHOP. All under one roof. It's the best value in DFS, hands down. We've even got a free roll tonight NBA-wise before I run off and start talking hockey. Thursday night, full slate, free roll, super draft. Open to the public, just sign up on the website and get in there. The winner gets a free 30-day subscription to the full VIP of DFSArmy.com. There's Super Draft cash to the top 65 places. I'll put the link in the comment section as well. But the bottom line is, why not take that shot at winning a free month? Even if you're already a member, get a refund. You know, I mean, it's pretty darn simple. We're giving away prizes left and right. Our members are winning cash like crazy. We're over $750,000 in cumulative winnings for our VIPs already, and we're not even all the way through February yet. This is going to be a crazy year. Hopefully you're inside. Hopefully you're taking in the coaching. Let's dive into the NHL side of things. And the first tool that I always look at is the research station. I like to look at implied team totals. When I don't find one, I run off to a site like VegasInsider.com, and I can look at all sorts of numbers over there and start picking apart which games are good. And this Toronto-Pittsburgh game is going to be one of the good games on the slate tonight, at least on paper. If it's not an outlier on the bad side, it's going to be a good game. You can look at this tool and see over the last 10 games, last 5 games, who the scoring lines are and who's doing the producing. There's more producing up here, 6 goals, 10 assists, than there is down here on the second line, 3 and 6, respectively. So you might focus on that top line. But if you focus on that top line, what you're going to need is another stack somewhere, or at the very least, value one-offs. Showed you how to find the value one-offs in the skaters tab the other day by sorting by price, by sorting by fantasy points per game, etc. But if you're looking for a value stack, like last night on paper, it didn't really work out, but Anaheim was a pretty good stack on paper, and that allowed you Boston's top line if you wanted to, or anybody else that you wanted to on that particular night, because that Anaheim 3 line was so cheap. It didn't pan out, didn't work out for us. It worked out over the last few games we'd been using them, but it didn't work out specifically last night, so oh well, chalk it up to another day. But if we could find another stack like that, we could then run into the top line in Pittsburgh. We could then run into the top line in Washington tonight, because if I scroll down a little bit and show you the Washington situation, probably the highest implied team total on the slate at a 3.6. So Washington facing Montreal is slated to score a lot of goals. And we see the production coming out of the second line more so than the top line. Top line's two goals, 3 assists. The second line is 6 goals, 7 assists. So you're looking for the value in the production, and that we've got a stack finder tool that will do that I'm going to open up in just one second. But the thing I want to explain to you about Washington is this is going to be a tricky night tonight. If you can find some value elsewhere, you might focus on that top line with Ovechkin. Why? Because Ovechkin's a goal scorer, just a scoring machine. 9 goals in his last 10 games on 55 flipping shots. However, in his last 5 games, he's gone really cold with no goals. I promise you that number is going to flip soon. I don't know if it's going to flip tonight, but I know it's going to come back on and get back on more of a pace like this pretty soon. If tonight's the night, you pay up for him in a tournament. Maybe people have been burned by him the last few games and they're off of him. They're fading him and whatever else. You can use a little bit of an ownership pivot to jump back on him maybe before everybody else. It's a good smart play. The other smart play would be if you get the sense that because this is the top offense on the night, everybody's going to be just using top line from the top offense, move on. That kind of mindless thinking, you can use some leverage against that as well by dropping to the second line and playing these guys instead. You've got the better production as a result of it. So if that production continues, you get a little bit lower ownership. You're still in that top game. You're still in that, you know, top producing spot, and you're actually using the players that have been producing the last five games more so than the players that were producing, you know, more traditionally. So you get leverage in a couple of different ways. If you sense that Ovechkin is being faded by the industry, you can gain leverage by playing him and going overweight on him tonight. If you sense that the second line is going to be under-owned compared to the top line because people are just going to play the top line in the top offense, you go down here to the second line and you get a little bit lower ownership in the top game that way as well, or in the top offensive side of that top game. Now, we can confirm a little bit with the FanDuel Stack Finder. This is one of my favorite tools when I really want to dive in and get moving and finding value stacks. I can see the salary here for the line. Tampa Bay, how would I do that? I click on this, I open it up, Nikita Kucherov, Steven Stamkos, Braden Point comprise that top line. Add their salaries up 8.4, 8.6, and 7.5 to get 24.5. I can do the same thing over here for line two. I can use Palat, Cirelli, Killorn, and add their salaries up 4.9, 4.9, 4.8 for 14.6. I can see projections. 47 points here, 26 points here. Oh my gosh, I want to run the top line. Well, yeah, but at that price, do you want to? I can look at some recent numbers here, get an average value that they've been bringing per player and per stack at 1.93 average value if I ran all three of those guys together versus 1.84 for these three guys together. And basically, in terms of value, it's largely the same, 1.84 versus 1.93, right? So if I want to save a little money, I can go here and get about the same production per dollar that I get here. That's one way to look at things. So when I close that back up, I can come down here to the average value and I can say 2.1, 2.15, 2.38. Well, 2.38 is probably the best. That's Winnipeg's top line. Interesting. 15.5. That's pretty cheap compared to some of these others over 20,000. I might start there for my value. In fact, it's cheaper than the second line and it's bringing more value than the second line. That's very interesting. I can come down here and see, is there a dud on that line? If I open up the top line, I end up with who? Shifley, Ehlers, and Kopp. This line needs to probably change around a little bit because I saw where it was Connor, Kopp, and Laine. So it, you can also add this up when you find a discrepancy. You go to a daily faceoff and find that the lines have changed. Then you can also run through this, open these up, and then do this stuff manually yourself. It's more tedious, of course. But as a general rule, this tool works really, really well. If this is the line that's intact, of course, the top line, then I'm going to sit here and I'm going to say, Shifley is the kind of the higher price guy, but he's also the dud of this group. 3,500 for Kopp at 2.7x is pretty strong. 2.5x for Ehlers is pretty strong. If Shifley has a big game, I've got some access to the assists, or, you know, if Shifley sets one of these guys up for a goal, I get the goal. If I run Ehlers and Kopp as a pair and then just run out. Last five games, 2.67x for Josh Morrissey. It's also pretty strong. I can tie Morrissey in on that top defensive pairing and get access to Shifley that way too. Ehlers, Morrissey, Kopp is a cheap value stack that I can then, in a good game, in a good situation tonight, playing a weaker defense, and then I can run off and stack that top Washington line or that top Pittsburgh line or that top Toronto line if that's what I want to do. I can look to the second line and see if there's any other kinds of plays there that might also be somebody that I'm a little bit worried about. When it comes down to these three players here, Connor, Laine, Wheeler, I can see that right now Laine is the dud. So I've got 2.4x, 2.3x. I may decide to run a pair there with Morrissey. That works too. Or if I find some overlap on a power play using our power play stack finder, which works just the same, let's say Kopp's on the power play one, but he correlates with these two guys on the two because these guys are on the power play one as well. I might find a power play one stack to use. These are all getting a little bit sophisticated, a little bit fancy for beginning players, but the tool will show you how to poke through there and find that value. I'll look at Washington just to kind of close things out here. If I'm looking at Washington, I've got 19-7 for the top line and 16-8 for the second line. The second line at, what, 1.94x versus the top line at 2.15x is a little bit weaker, but, you know, and it's not that much less expensive. It's not that much of a savings. So I could look here for these types of guys and keep these as just a pair, or I could come up here and run all three of these guys, being that they're over a 2x, and just run this line straight away. Again, the option is yours, but the tool will show you some obvious spots. If I scroll over to line three, because sometimes we will use line three, I see that there's not a lot of obvious spots here that are bringing a ton of intense value. A little bit of Pittsburgh line three, a little bit of New Jersey line three, but that's about it. I'd be focused more in these second lines. I'd be looking at the pricing for the cheaper cost of these lines, and I might pick one or two to run some value stacks. That was a defensive pair, actually. But somebody like this at 16-8 is bringing some value for relatively cheap. And then somebody up here at 15-5 is one of the cheaper top lines that you can actually have in all of hockey. Putting those two together, the Winnipeg value line one and the, who was it, the Pittsburgh line two? The Pittsburgh line two and the Winnipeg line one gets me two offenses in two pretty good spots tonight. Gets me two lines that are actually producing some value. They're definitely going to be a little bit lower owned, because people are going to be focused on line one in Pittsburgh other than line two. And then I could bring in a one-off like an Ovechkin, probably. I could bring in a one-off like a John Carlson in Washington, maybe get some exposure to that game that way. These are just different ways to think about the slate, different ways to think about how to use the tools at DFSArmy.com. It's a little overwhelming until you get into a normal routine that you like to use. You may look at the cheat sheets and then go looking up the numbers, or you may look up the numbers and then go look at the cheat sheets. It's totally up to you how you want to use these tools. But the object is to use these tools to formulate your own thoughts and then get inside our discussions and start asking the questions that are going to facilitate conversation. Because posting a lineup and just saying, hey, what do you think about this, isn't going to tell me crap. I don't know where you got your numbers from. I don't know where you got your ideas from. I have no idea. All I know is that if you say, hey, I'm thinking about this line or that line, and the reason why is because I'm contemplating getting my value out of the second line versus the first line in Washington, now you're giving me some direction. Now we can talk, and I can help you through some of these things, and we can find a flaw, or we can give you the encouragement that you need to be confident in the line that you built. That's the whole idea behind DFSArmy.com and where that coaching really comes into play as you're learning these new sports. And once again, every sport under one roof. You can't beat the value anywhere else. If we're looking for value stacks, you might as well look for a value content provider inside the DFS industry, and that would be us, DFSArmy.com. I'm chopping on. I'm going to head out of here. I'm going to go talk a little bit of hockey with the boys. NBA is back. PGA locks here in a little bit if you're interested in that one as well. And then we're going to start talking spring training and baseball coming up here in a couple of weeks. So we've got a lot going on inside DFS Army. Hopefully you become a part of it. Would love to see you on the inside learning to become a better player yourself. DFSArmy.com, over $750,000 in cumulative winnings for our VIPs this year, and we're only going to push it over a couple of $1 million by year's end. Hopefully you get your piece of the pie. Hopefully you're in here, and I will be talking to you very, very soon. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and we'll release videos more and more as time goes on. Take care, everybody. See you later.